I think it will make us more human, because when you look at a lot of the jobs that people have, they're very robotic in nature. They're very undignified. They're very, a lot of them are inhumane. Like, you know, the Facebook moderators, there's 15,000 of them in the world, and they sit there all day looking up like the most horrific, violent, and hate speech and pornographic images, and people are having panic attacks. People are massively struggling, massively underperforming their potential, massively not making ends meet. And I think that when we have the ability for technology to meet our basic human needs for everyone on the planet, then that unlocks a lot of potential for individuals to be more creative, to be more engaged in their families and their communities, and just be like a more full human being.
Really interesting question is how do you get to the root cause of what drives people, and then find ways for them to look at their opportunities through that? Right, and companies are starting to do the hard work to actually map things that way. Not a lot of them, but some of them are, where they basically go back and they look at a function and they actually say, what are the essentially like the core aspects of this function that make a successful individual in this role? Forget what they do, like just what are the traits, what are the abilities, what are the natural things that people that essentially make them stand out.
How do people fit into this new way of working? From my perspective as a designer, it's how do we as humans interact with technology and do things in a way that we want to do, as opposed to ways that, you know, computers want us to do things. There are all these amazing emerging technology coming out, AI, machine learning, blockchain, VR, AR, opens up the possibility, bring the human back into it and kind of really enable us to do work for why we go to work and kind of wake up and that purpose of work and the joy of working together and on teams. You know, no one wakes up in the morning and goes to work to read off a script in a call center, you know, or to, you know, click on Facebook images. They go to, you know, and they go to work because they have to. They have to have a means to live. But what if we could really enable people to do what they do best, what people do best, and remove that kind of robotic nonsense and let, you know, kind of bring back the empathy to life? You know, I think a lot of the reports of, 56% of jobs will change, but when you actually drive into that statistic, it's like 30% of the job will be kind of automated. And there's really only about 5% of jobs that exist and roles that exist that can be fully automated. Because the reality is what we do at work is a whole bunch of random disparate tasks and different sort of skills. And so that's not so easy to automate. So there are, of course, some certain types of jobs that can be automated, but I would kind of argue that those would be the things that are not what brings, you know, you don't go to work because you're super amped on it for those 5% of jobs. I think those are the very monotonous tasks that a machine can do better, most likely, and really isn't something that you're excited about.